little bit of warmth out there for us. It's been a nice day today, a little bit of a breeze, some veiled sunshine, which you see with our Kentucky One Health weather bug camera, that one located at EKU there in Richmond. It's been kind of a thin, real thin overcast off and on during the day today, but still sunshine, and it did get warm. Max Track Live Doppler is quiet now. It shall not be that way tomorrow, and especially tomorrow night. On Halloween, haunting wind leads to rain. It's going to be a windy, rainy afternoon, late afternoon into the evening for a lot of us. For the end of the week, tracking a month's worth of water in about a day and a half. Cat's Cast, Saturday. The day will end better than it starts. Clouds are under and cold, but the day does get better with more sunshine on Saturday. We have a flood watch that's in effect. This is going to be through Thursday evening. It runs essentially along Highway 68 and then down toward I-64. So you see some of the counties affected, and again, it's more north and west. Lexington is included, runs down to Danville, continues on toward Campbellsville. That again for the potential of locally heavy rain. The swath of rain remains basically in place. Rainfall amounts, a pretty general 2 to 4 inches covers a broad area within that flood watch. It's not so much that it's going to rain terribly hard for a long period of time leading to flash flooding, but more of just a long-term moderate rain that can lead to some creek and river rises. So we'll keep an eye on that. Lesser amounts as we look off to the south and southeast. So as we look to rain chances, well, they're zero here through this evening and into tomorrow morning. Middle of the day, we see those chances beginning to arc up into the probable category. As we get on into Thursday, then it goes into almost metaphysical certitude that at some point on Thursday, it will be raining. So here we go. High pressure is sliding off to the east. Here comes your cold front. That cold front combined with that area of low pressure, that's the combination that's going to be leading to this prolonged bout of rain. And again, the flood potential that's out there. Meanwhile, a nice little snow out across the southern Rockies. So your Halloween. Now I know some trick-or-treaters going this evening. Be ready for those kids, by the way. As we get you into Halloween itself, at noon, you can see the rain beginning to encroach on the northwestern part of the air. But you notice, even by 6 o'clock, southeast Kentucky probably not in the rain yet. So your Halloween goes along just fine. But for areas along I-64 and then back to the north and northwest, that rain will become increasingly likely and increasingly heavy through tomorrow night. Then the front gets into the area and puts the brakes on, because that area of low pressure to the southwest, it's slowing the front down. So here we are late Thursday, and you see that rain continuing. Temperatures, hey, we were mild today and maybe milder tomorrow, and then we see things tail off as we head towards Saturday. Right now, it's nice. We've got 70s in the I-65 corridor and west. Hey, we're content with middle upper 60s, although 71 in Monticello, not too shabby. Bluegrass Airport, we sit at 66, south wind at 10. That's after a high today of 67. For tonight, partly to mostly cloudy, breezy, warm. We'll drop down to the mid-50s tomorrow. Some early sun, but then the clouds will arrive and thicken. Rain and thunder perhaps later part of the afternoon into the evening. We'll look at that rain getting heavy for us tomorrow night. So again, for some folks, trick-or-treating will be fine tomorrow night. Other folks, again, getting to do it tonight. Weather is better tonight regardless.
Yeah. Much better tonight. That was a very wise decision on the part of so many communities to change it.
And again,
tonight.
Southeast Kentucky may not see the rain until tomorrow night.
Oh, yeah. Cool.
Thanks, Bill.
More news after this.